Hello students of standard 6. We had done the first part of the lesson number 2, that is journey from primitive man to settled life. Today we'll do the next part of the lesson. As I told you last time, the next part of the lesson deals with two important discoveries of the primitive man. The first one is the discovery of fire. Now see, the story as it says that fire was discovered accidentally. Say sometimes it may have happened that they were rubbing stones. Two stones, and while rubbing stones, what happens if you rub them very hard? What happens? There is friction, and friction causes what? Sparks. And because of that spark, the fire happened. Okay, so first of all, how can we say that the primitive man knew about fire? Because you know, wherever the caves of primitive man are found, over there we also find ashes. Ashes mean what? Rock. When can ashes be formed? Only when there is fire. Okay, so ash is possible only if there is fire. So we can say that the primitive man knew about fire. And they discovered it accidentally, okay. And they started using fire how many? Approximately 11,000 years ago, the primitive man started using fire. Now what were the uses of fire? First of all, cook meat. See, earlier what did the primitive man do? They used to hunt animals and they used to eat the raw meat. Okay, they used to eat the flesh just as it is. But one day, there is another story which goes like this, that one day what must have happened? Say a piece of meat fell into fire. So say if there is a fire and a piece of meat falls into the fire, okay. So after the primitive man took it out from the fire and he ate it, what happened? The meat became softer and tastier. So that is how they got the idea of cooking. See, even today, when we don't eat raw vegetables, all the vegetables, we don't eat them raw. What do? We cook them on fire and then we eat it. Why? Because when we cook it, what happens? It becomes soft. Okay, so same thing happened with the primitive man, and he observed what? That the meat, when it is cooked in fire, it becomes soft and it becomes more tasty, and that is why they started cooking their food on fire. This is how they got the idea of cooking. Next is, fire gave them light. Even at our homes, when it is night time and we don't have electricity, what do? We light up a candle, right? So fire gave them light. Now, fire, what was the next use of fire? It protected them from wild animals. You know, primitive man, generally what they used to do is, they lived in caves, that is what we learned. Now see, outside their caves, say this is the cave in which the primitive man is living. Outside the cave, they used to keep a fire on. So that what happened? The wild animals would get scared and the wild animals would not attack them. Okay, तो वाइल्ड एनिमल्स से बचने के लिए वो लोग क्या करते थे? अपने केव के बाहर ऐसे फायर लगा के रखते थे ताकि वाइल्ड एनिमल्स उनको अटैक नहीं करते. एंड वन मोर यूज ऑफ फायर वॉज गेट वॉर्म्थ इन विंटर. इन विंटर व्हेन इट इज वेरी कोल्ड, व्हाट कुड दे डू? दे कुड लिट अ फायर एंड सिट अराउंड द फायर. सो द फायर गेव देम वॉर्म्थ इन विंटर. So this is what is written. See, discovery of fire. How do we know that they used fire? Because ashes have been found. Now see, I am reading page number 8. Discovery of fire and wheel and their uses. Ruins of ashes found in the caves of the primitive man in Kurnool in South India indicate that they were familiar with fire. Familiar means they knew about fire. As per historians, approximately 11,000 years ago, humans started using fire. So approximately how many years ago did human beings start using fire? Is 11,000. Use of fire had revolutionized their life, because with the help of fire they could cook meat and eat, get light, protect themselves from wild animals. So all these are the points that I have written over here. What are the uses of fire? So cooking meat, getting light, protect from wild animals, and getting warmth in winter. So this is how fire helped the primitive man. So this was the discovery of fire, and we still use it today. Okay. Now the next important discovery of the primitive man was the wheel. You know, they, what did they find out? Say if there is a log of wood, Say for example, this is the trunk of a tree. So this is called a log of wood. What did they observe? That the log of wood keeps rolling. And seeing that rolling log of wood, they got the idea of the wheel. Okay, so again, wheel brought a revolution. Revolutionize means bring a big change in someone's life. That is called revolution. So it brought a revolution, it revolutionized the life of the primitive man. Okay, and how was this wheel made? From the trunk of the tree. Okay, then they could cut it like this and make it even thinner and like that. But how did they get the idea of wheel is by a rolling log of wood. And what did they do after that? They started making carts. You know, then they started keeping some animals as their domestic animals near their caves or their houses, their huts. And then they made carts and tied them to the animals. So wheel, from wheel they got the idea of making carts. Plus we all are also very familiar with potter's wheel. You know, when a potter has to make pots, what do they use? They use a wheel. So you can see those pictures, okay? So with the help of the internet facility, if you have it at home, what you can do is you can gather more information about, say, the discovery of fire and the discovery of wheel. This is a really nice topic, okay? And one more important thing that brought about change in the life of human beings is agriculture. Now see what is written over here. Say for the wheel, what is written? Other than fire, wheel also revolutionized the life. Means revolution means brought a complete change. They learned to make wheel from the trunk of the tree. And how did they make the wheel from the trunk of a tree? Now reading the next part. See, changing environment. What happened? Around 12,000 years ago, there was a change in the environment throughout the world. Okay, and what was that change in the environment? The temperature increased. Means garmi dheere dheere badhti gayi. Garmi badhegi to kya hoga? Plants bhi badhenge. Plants badhenge to kya hoga? Plants khane wale animals bhi badhenge. Okay, so understand this whole thing. See, all this goes in a link. ये एक दूसरे के साथ सब कनेक्टेड है. सी टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज, सो व्हाट हैपेंड? वेजिटेशन आल्सो इंक्रीज. यू नो प्लांट्स नीड सनलाइट टू ग्रो, दे नीड वार्मथ. ओके, सो द प्लांट्स गॉट इनफ सनलाइट, सो मोर प्लांट्स ग्रू. सो मोर टेम्परेचर, मोर वेजिटेशन. मोर वेजिटेशन, सो मोर नंबर ऑफ हर्बीवोरस एनिमल्स. सो द नंबर ऑफ हर्बीवोरस एनिमल्स ऑल्सो इंक्रीज. Now I'm reading that part from your textbook. Changing environment. Around 12,000 years ago, there was widespread change in the atmosphere of the world. So there was a great change in the atmosphere. Due to increase in temperature, vegetation and grass fields started growing. So because of increasing temperature, vegetation also increased. Because of this curious instinct, slowly agriculture started in India. So vegetation increased, and so what did increase is agriculture. People started using stones to grow grains. They started growing grains near the banks of river and constructed houses made up of mud, thatch and other materials in the nearby areas. Now see, agriculture, you know, after wheel and fire, number one, fire. Second important discovery was the wheel, and the third important is agriculture. After agriculture, what happened is people started living a settled life. So the primitive man started doing agriculture. Now understand one thing. See, why did they start living near the banks of the rivers? Now see, understand. Earlier, where did the primitive man live? In the cave. Okay, natural caves. But now after they started doing agriculture, they needed to stay at one place. Why? Because if you sow some seed, it will take some months to grow. So till that seed grows, you have to stay over there. So say for example, where are they doing agriculture? Near the banks of the river. Why near the banks of the river? Because water is available. But what happened is, everywhere near the river there cannot be a cave. So human beings started making huts. Okay, so understand one thing. पहले ह्यूमन बींग्स क्या रहते थे, प्रिमिटिव मैन क्या रहते थे, केव्स में। धीरे धीरे एग्रीकल्चर करना स्टार्ट किया, एग्रीकल्चर करना स्टार्ट किया, सो वॉट एवर सीड्स दे हैव ग्रोन, इट विल टेक टाइम टू ग्रो। सीड्स को ग्रो होने में टाइम लगेगा 2-3 महीने, तो उनको उधर ही रहना पड़ेगा। और हर एक रिवर के पास केव होगी, नो। सो वॉट डिड दे डू, दे स्टार्टेड मेकिंग हट्स सो दैट दे गॉट इनफ वाटर, वाटर फॉर वॉट, वाटर फॉर द क्रॉप्स एंड वाटर फॉर देमसेल्व्स। सो दे गॉट वाटर फ्रॉम द रिवर एंड दैट इज हाउ दे स्टार्टेड लिविंग नियर द रिवर्स। ओके, सो दे केम इन कॉन्टैक्ट, आई एम रीडिंग द लास्ट पैराग्राफ ऑन पेज नंबर 8। दे केम इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद ग्रास, ट्रीज, वेजिटेशन एज वेल एज वीट, बार्ली एंड अदर ग्रेन्स ड्यू टू क्लाइमेटिक चेंज। वी हैड लर्नड दिस अर्लियर ऑल्सो दैट वीट एंड बार्ली वेर द फर्स्ट क्रॉप्स दैट वर ग्रोन बाय द प्रिमिटिव मैन। बाई यूजिंग स्टोन्स मैन, वुमेन एंड चिल्ड्रन कलेक्टेड ग्रेन्स। बिकॉज ऑफ दिस क्यूरियस इंस्टिंक्ट, स्टोलीज एग्रीकल्चर स्टार्टेड इन इंडिया। सो आफ्टर फायर एंड बील, द थर्ड इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज एग्रीकल्चर। People started using stones to grow grains. They started growing grains near the banks of rivers and constructed huts. So where did they do agriculture? Near the banks of the river. And they started making their huts because caves cannot be there everywhere near the bank of the river. So they used their intelligence and they started making huts. As a result, their nomadic life came to an end. Now see, nomadic life, nomadic means just moving from one place to another. उनका कोई घर था नहीं था, तो इधर उधर घूमते रहते थे, पर अब वो बंद हो गया। Now they have to live a settled life, they have to stay at the same place. The first companion or friend of his settled life was dog. Now see, which was the first animal that was domesticated, was a dog. Besides, he was also familiar with sheep, goat, cow, buffalo and pig. These are the other animals, but the first you will remember, dog. These animals protected them from wild animals. Thus, they associated with animal husbandry and then they started animal husbandry. Animal husbandry means you keep these animals and these animals give birth to more babies and you take care of those babies. So, this is how the number of animals increase. Okay. So this is what they started doing. Now I'm reading page number 9. Settled life. Now see, the nomadic life came to an end. Nomadic, moving from one place to another, came to an end. And now they settled at one place. Ek jagah par hi rehne lage. How? After the beginning of agriculture. Early life and pastoral activity. Pastoral means agricultural activity. Transform primitive man's life to a settled life. So after agriculture, the primitive man started living at the same place. We know that agriculture land cannot be left out because it takes time to for the crops to grow. Now see, if I want to do agriculture, there is a piece of land, I put some seeds. It is not going to grow in 1 or 2 days. It will take some months to grow. So till then, I'll have to stay over there. This process led to the beginning of settled life. He also started making earthen pots. Okay, now see, with agriculture what happened? They started getting a lot of food grains. Agriculture start kiya, toh bahut zyada food grains bhi milne lage. Ab food grains mile hai, toh wo ek din mein toh kha nahi jayenge sab food grains. Unko food grains store karke rakhne padenge. So unhone kya sikha? Earthen pots. Now see. Earthen pots mean मिट्टी के pots बनाने लगे। Why? Because they had to store the grains. Okay, आज भी हम अलग अलग बड़े बड़े tins में हम grain store करके रखते हैं हमारे घर में। So when they started agriculture, they started getting more grains. Now if they are getting more grains, they'll have to learn how to store it. So they started making big earthen pots, बड़े बड़े मिट्टी के pots बनाने लगे। As the wandering life came to an end, there was a widespread change in food habits. Now see, they started growing different types of grains. So the food habits also changed. Clothes and shelter, earlier they used to live in caves. Now they live in the huts. Now they have a settled life. Earlier they used to just move from one place to another. Now they are living at the same place. Along with wheat, barley, meat, they started eating fish and fruit. So what all did they eat? Wheat, barley, meat, fish, fruits. They lived in houses made up of mud, thatch and such other material. They started making their houses. They did agriculture. He made farm implements of stone using spade, including spade, chisel and sickle. All these are the implements that we use in farming. Say for example, the spade, it has a long handle and a thing like this. Okay, chisel is like this. So they started making different implements to cut the grains and for different purposes of agriculture. Okay, so this is how from a wandering life, from a nomadic life, the primitive man started living a settled life after he started with agriculture.